On behalf of the class of 2016, I would like to welcome each of you to our 52nd annual commencement exercise. We are pleased that you are here tonight to share with us as our final hours of West Effort High School students. To begin tonight's program, please rise and honor the United States of America with the playing of the national anthem.
Good evening, and welcome, Board of Education members, administration, faculty and staff, friends, and family, to the class of 2016's commencement ceremony. So, my name is Matt West, and I know that because it says so on that piece of paper they handed you when you walked in. So, I'm very happy to be the first one speaking, because I still have everyone's attention, so that's a definite plus. Now for the speech. We all learn from high school, right? I mean, that was kind of the point. We all learned our math, our English. We learned the exact time the dismissal bell rings. Trust me, I had those down by the first day. But among all that learning, I learned something unusual too. Perhaps the most important thing I could have learned. I learned how to fail. That's right, I learned how to fail. I bet you didn't expect me to say that. Failure means that test you want to do well on, you just didn't get the grade. Failure means that sport that you play, you just missed varsity. Failure means procrastinating, even though you said you wouldn't, all that work until the days before it is due, and then waiting until that night to start. I'm super guilty of that one. I must have lost so much sleep that it probably stunted my growth. So. I learned that failure stinks and is nearly unavoidable sometimes. Failure is defeat, complete and utter. Or is it? I think it depends on how you look at it. All those things I said about failure can be true, but they do not have to be. Allow me. We all strive for success, right? I mean, I've never heard anyone tell me that all they wanted to do was fail. If they did, I would have been pretty awe-stricken. The funny part is, though, failure defines success. It's crazy, I know. It's almost as crazy as asking a girl to prom on the airplane back from senior trip using the intercom. But both of these things are true. Yeah, her name was Allison, yeah. So, without knowing the bitter taste, the hollow rejection, the emptiness that accompanies failure, success is impossible to know. It is like when you have to get braces. It hurts a lot, so thanks a lot, Mom and Dad. But then your teeth look great, so thanks, Mom and Dad. And that joke wasn't even funny. Thank you for laughing at that. Another thing, failure means sometimes you're not strong enough. It means that you found your limit. However, I would like to rephrase that. I like to do that with a lot of things. Like with this rain, I know some people are going to say the rain forced us inside, but I'd rather look at it as the rain gave us air conditioning. So, failure means you're not strong enough this time, and now you're presented with a limit that you can break, which is just fantastic. You can learn from your failure, fix your mistake, rise back up, and succeed, just like Batman. I said it wrong. Even if you fail, it just means that you've challenged yourself again and will continue to get stronger and grow. So why am I telling you all this? I could have picked something really awesome for my graduation speech, some really cool story about how we did something stupid and hilarious, and we all have many of them, I bet. And then I could also say how we're also going to go into our future and achieve all of our dreams. Well, there are two reasons. One is I wanted to be different. I literally love being different in every aspect of life just for being different. Ask anyone that knows me, like everything. So more importantly though, I want you to know that failing is okay. In fact, I can guarantee you one thing. In this life, whatever road you take, you will fail more than once, easily. If you don't fail, you did it wrong. That's really ironic. I love that line. In other words, if you manage to never fail, even in the slightest, you missed out on what is a great opportunity. So don't be afraid of failure, because one day, it may be just what you need. I look forward to life getting even harder, facing all my impending failures, and getting even less sleep than I already do, so near the number zero. One other thing that I would like to add, high school not only taught us, but it gave us an indispensable gift. The great invention of lunchtime. Of course, that isn't really it, but. High school gave us friends. Friends that will last a lifetime. That sounds corny, and I hate corny, but it's true, so I couldn't bring myself to not include it. Hopefully, I won't forget many of your names. However, it is in that ever so delightful human nature to do so. So that may be true, but I won't forget you, and I know that I will take a few of you with me for the rest of my life. One last thing, I wanted to thank everyone for being so awesome, classmates and teachers alike. It shaped me into the person I am today. I wouldn't have had it any other way. So, no graduation speech is complete without a quote. I mean, come on. So, I think I would like to end with a quote of one of my classmates. I'll end with this. West Everett High School class of 2016, get out there and get one. Thanks, everybody.
Each year, the graduating class selects a special faculty member to honor at our commencement ceremony. This year, the class of 2016's honoree is Mr. Jared Beer. Presented to Mr. Jared Beer, in grateful recognition of service to West Stepford High School, class of 2016, at its commencement ceremony.
Good evening, members of the West Stepford Township Board of Education, colleagues, parents, family members, and primarily, graduating class of 2016. Thank you for the honor of addressing you this evening upon this special occasion. For this occasion is special. Despite the fact that each of you is one of a few million high school students across the country, anxiously anticipating receiving his or her diploma, that long-awaited symbol that signifies the completion of your traditional state-mandated schooling, this occasion is truly special. If it were not, we would not bother celebrating, certainly not in this fashion. As this night represents the culmination of your experiences and achievements within the formalized academic setting, however, you and all those in attendance tonight, your administrators, teachers, guidance counselors, family members, and friends, are here to celebrate. You are feeling the significance of your achievement, and well, you should. For some of you, this achievement has come relatively easily. For others, you have spent the last 12 years consistently studying and practicing, scrambling between the due dates, clawing your way through those challenges. The quizzes, the tests, the essays, the lab reports, and those good, healthy paragraphs through your last final examination earlier this week. But regardless of how you managed to arrive at this point, this occasion is special, and as such, you should celebrate. This night, with its pageantry and ceremony and music and the photographs and the many congratulations, as well as the gatherings and get-togethers to come, is for you and about you. In this respect, this occasion is special, and you, for having attained an achievement of such significance, are special. However, at some point in the near future, perhaps tomorrow or Monday morning or next month or someday toward the end of the summer, your circumstances will one way or another redirect your attention back to the immediate demands of reality. At some point, it will be time to get back to the classroom, or the job, or the playing field. And at that point, in spite of the elation and sense of accomplishment you are presently feeling, the celebrating must eventually end, and you will then return to the grind. Tasks will need to be completed, and you will find yourself, much like you did up until tonight, working towards something. And at that point, it will be easy as you steer your concentration toward these new demands to continue thinking that these new experiences, much like tonight, are about you. After all, that class in which you will be enrolled or that job at which you will work should ultimately serve to benefit you. In this regard, we tend to consider ourselves contestants in the so-called rat race, striving to get ahead, striving to be successful, knowing that however we define success is at least in part determined by virtue of the fact that some people very rarely fail. In fact, our biological makeup steers us toward this presumption. We are outfitted with the instinct to self-preserve, and it is this instinct that drives us to compete, consume, and ultimately get ahead. Instinctively, life is about me, and for each of you, instinctively, life is about you. This instinct, of course, is only furthermore encouraged and reinforced culturally. We are told that we can have things our way, that we deserve the best, that we are the best. We are told that we deserve to be entertained, that we deserve to be heard, that our photographs and comments deserve to be liked and retweeted. We are told that ultimately, above all else, we deserve to be happy. I don't need to specify those outlets to which I am alluding. You need look no further than the personal device you carry on your person to understand my point. And I know you all do, because you drove me crazy with it all year, but that's okay. You are the sole target of a personalized marketing campaign that aims to inform you that your happiness should be prioritized by the world around you. Now, you can spend your entire life following that logic, approaching each new relationship and experience under the impression that life really is about you. Actually, I would propose that most people, in fact, do approach each relationship and experience in this manner. And many in so doing have attained enviable material success, not to mention intermittent happiness. But there exists in that scenario a complicated truth with which you and I will spend the rest of our lives contending. Happiness is, at best, temporary. Happiness is only circumstantial, occurring with direct correlation to the ways in which those relationships and experiences in some way serve us. Given the right circumstances, then, anybody can be happy. But realistically, how often does any one of us find ourselves entirely in the midst of the right, quote unquote, circumstances? What good is happiness if it is entirely dependent upon what we can only partially control? Please do not deduce from these comments that I do not wish that each and every one of you achieve your goals as you proceed with this next impending phase of your life. I absolutely do. However, there is a truth that I would encourage you to consider as you strive toward those goals. It is a truth that we may not care to regularly admit, but if you make an effort to consider it, you will attain something that is worth much more than happiness. To be fulfilled is greater than to be happy. And it is my belief that fulfillment is attained when we realize that life, unlike we feel and what we've been told, is not about us. Actually, life is about those around us. To be fulfilled is to give of ourselves every day, in essence, denying that instinct to self-preserve at its most basic level. If we desire relationships and experiences that are truly fulfilling, we must approach those relationships and experiences looking to serve not ourselves, but others. This, of course, will vary in appearance within the context of each relationship and experience, but fundamentally, the truth holds that to be fulfilled is to combat that innate, primal concern for ourselves and consider what and how we can give of our time and energy for those around us. This is not so much a distant objective to progressively work toward as it is a practice that, if we are serious about not just wanting to be happy every now and then, we will have to execute and retread every day. Giving of ourselves by listening, encouraging, empathizing, investing time is not easy, but it is absolutely fulfilling. Each of us here tonight has been the beneficiary of somebody else's encouragement and empathy. If that were not the case, most of us would probably not be fortunate enough to be here. Thank you for a fun and memorable school year. And thank you for giving me the opportunity to conclude such a fun and memorable school year in this way. And I'm going to break from script here, and I just want you to know, you are a great class. I truly enjoyed it. I truly enjoyed teaching you guys. So I wish each and every one of you success, and above all else, fulfillment in your next endeavor. Thank you.
Good evening, members of the Board of Education, distinguished guests, fellow administrators, faculty and staff, parents, family, friends, and most especially the members of the graduating class of 2016. To the parents and family members in the audience, I can commend and thank you for giving us such an outstanding class to work with. They would not be sitting here this evening without the love, support, and guidance that you have gave them along the way. I would like to also take the opportunity to recognize the efforts, guidance, and support provided to these students by the administrators, faculties and staffs of the high school, the middle school, and our three elementary schools. These students have benefited greatly from the time that they've spent with such an outstanding group of educators. I'm here to recognize this class for a job well done and to bid them farewell. Tonight, these students take the first step in the beginning of the next chapter of their lives, be that higher education, service, the working world, or all the above. This truly is a special class that I've gotten to know well. As I look around at the parents and students in the field, I'm not in the field anymore, obviously. I can't stop thinking about how much time I've spent with a lot of you in this room. I've watched this class grow up from the time they were in elementary school all the way to adulthood. As an elementary principal, I was introduced to a third of the class as kindergartners and was experienced a portion of your childhood that led to many great memories for me. Then we all met up as a group when I became principal of the middle school and you entered the fifth grade. This class was the first pilot group to get laptops and everyone in the district was jealous. During this time, I was able to see the transition from children to young adults. I left this excitable group of pre-teenagers and I moved my career here to the high school as they were entering the seventh grade. People say that I'm following their children, but personally, I think they're following me. Anyway, I have had the pleasure and honor to walk side by side with the students of this graduating class. I've been able to say for the years during my graduation speeches that principals in this country can only dream to be me. And I said that last year. Why? Well, because I've had the honor and I've had given the gift to witness their changes socially, physically, emotionally, and academically. To say that I had a part of it, well, think about it. Imagine how you feel now as parents. You sit here, you're proud and overjoyed that your child is sitting on the stage today. Well, guess what? Times my feelings by 225 by these individuals sitting next to me tonight. I share with all of you those same emotions. I feel connected, excited, and proud of the fine young men and women that they've become. My success is because of them. They have been my family. I have watched them grow. I have watched them reach maturity. And for this, I want to thank all of you for being such a great part of my life. Thank you. Yeah. Graduates, as you face the challenges that lie ahead, remember what you've learned and experienced here. You may encounter difficulties along the way, but have already demonstrated that you have the ability to rise above all of those challenges. I encourage you to always keep trying and to never give up. Please be proud of all of your accomplishments, not only for yourself, but for the future students who will soon follow you in graduation. You become tonight, like myself, an alumnus to an excellent school district that continues to be in the forefront of education at all times. Class of 2016, I congratulate you on your commencement, and as you face the challenges that lie ahead, never forget that you are, and you always will be, a West Stepford Eagle. Please remember to keep your eyes on the stars, stay grounded, and have a successful, happy future. Thank you. I would like everyone to know that the class of 2016 was offered approximately $1,246,500 in college scholarships and awards for their outstanding achievements. It's a larger number than we've had in the past. And on Tuesday, we were able to present 103 of our graduates with a total value of approximately $78,300 in local community scholarships and awards. These scholarships were made possible by the generous scholarships and various organizations and individuals listed at the commencement. At this time, I'd like to ask those students who received awards and scholarships on Tuesday evening to stand and be recognized for their achievements and accomplishments. Please give them a round of applause. Thank you. Graduates, you can be seated. It now gives me great pleasure to present the Golden Eagle Award. This award is presented to the best all-around student in the graduating class, outstanding performance in academics and co-curricular activities, citizenship, loyalty to the school, respect for fellow students and teachers,
This award recipient is selected by a vote of the entire high school staff. This is an extremely talented class with many students who contributed a great deal to the school and the community. The student will receive the traditional Golden Eagle Trophy as a representative of West Effort High School pride and a check in the amount of $500. It gives me great pleasure to announce the winner of the Golden Eagle Award for the class of 2016, Matthew McSorley. Round of applause for Matt. It now gives me great honor to present two seniors with the following award. It's the Robert A. Staub Memorial Award. For the third time in West Effort High School history, two of our graduating seniors will be receiving this next award in the amount of $10,000. This award is a very special one given in the memory of Robert A. Staub. Robert Staub and a few of his classmates died in an untimely death many years ago on Red Bank Avenue in the early 80s. The family felt indebted to the school, the teachers, the students, the parents, and the community of West Effort for all of their unconditional support during these hard times. The Staub family has been donating to our annual awards every year for the past several years. 4 years ago, West Effort High School was notified that the last living heir to the scholarship fund account has unfortunately passed away. With her passing, a trust fund and the entire estate was bequeathed to West Effort High School. With this trust fund, and by following the terms of their will, from today onward and every year, we will award two $10,000 scholarships to a male and female student who fit the following criteria. This criteria was stipulated by the Staub family in their will. The award will be given to a student who displays scholarship, thoughtfulness, kindness, and helpfulness to others. The female and male student must be in the top one-third of his or her class and must be a member of the National Honor Society. In addition, the students must participate in an interscholastic athlete with special consideration given to any male candidate who has participated in football as long as he has met all of the other criteria. The recipients of the two $10,000 Robert A. Staub Memorial Awards are, for the male, Nick Diaco. Female, Samantha Budd. Oh, another picture. Thank you. This weird smile stays here all day, just don't worry. I apologize. And now I have these fan visions that make it even worse. So I apologize for seeing me close up. At this time, I would like to introduce our valedictorian, Ms. Rasha Abulzadeh.
Hello. All right, how are we all? Good? Nice and not hot, right? Okay. Here we are, dressed in green and white, representing yet another class of West Effort High School that has served their time and earned their graduation. Before I get too into this speech, I want to take the time to selfie with my senior class. Sorry, I know many of you are anxiously anticipating my concluding speech, regardless the humidity, but you know, there's no humidity. For sure, the only thing on your mind is your graduation cap, which you cannot wait to chuck. Anyways, here it goes. All right, here we go. We'll get this side first. Those will be on Twitter. All right. Moving on, thank you to my mother for raising me correctly and my father for being my supporter. I also want to thank my brother, who has been my best friend from day one. And finally, thanks to all of my teachers and academic adjudicators from pre-K to senior year. Some of you contain a very special place in my heart. Without you, I wouldn't be up here. Many of you have been bantering me about this for the past couple of months, saying that there was no way my speech wouldn't be sappy or a walk through memory lane. Others told me that it would end up the size of my Miss Ferrari English essays, and they would faint from boredom, I guess. So I took the challenge. Thank you. Now, class of 2016, we've come a long way, haven't we? I want you all to take a moment and look at the person next to you. Now close your eyes and envision them in middle school. Try even elementary school. I can remember many of my and your middle school years, except I try to dismiss mine. They're far too frightening. Let's take a moment of silence to acknowledge all of our side bangs, braces, cracking voices, Uggs with shorts, and years of Aeropostale and Hollister. See, the aspect of this is, you may have never known the person sitting next to you, but the matter of a fact is, they may have moved from Florida and felt left out for a good period of time. They may have been homeschooled until high school, but swam their way to success. They may have just transferred to West Deptford this year, but here's the point. Today, they graduate just like you and me. Here we are, all together, taking our next step towards our future. In all honesty, if high school is supposed to be the best 4 years of our lives, then yikes. What are we doing moving on? We've gone through an arduous 4 years, some of us not even getting any sleep and switching to a nocturnal circadian rhythm. Others simply watched Grey's Anatomy or Game of Thrones and hoped for the best, especially during senior year. But most of us took the time to achieve what we put our minds to and ultimately deserved. These years are important enough to rapidly go through, since in a matter of months, majority of us will be freshmen again. Ah, freshmen and freshman year, what a time that was. Take a moment and recall your freshman year. I apologize in advance for asking this of you. Our freshman yearbook, unfortunately, does a nice job of haunting myself. Freshman year was superior at the time, but I guarantee half the things that came out of our mouths were extremely ridiculous. Gangtose and water cells are still not real things. Also, England is not France, and Obama has a first name. Diagramming made us believe in hell, and we began to question how math would ever help us at the grocery store. Basically, everyone was throwing things at us, and we did nothing but brand a ludicrous, confused face in return. As freshmen, we were too concerned with what was being thrown and never took the time to focus on ourselves. Next was sophomore year. Listen. That's it. Moving on, junior year. The one we never thought we would survive. Finally, we were upperclassmen, and regardless what anyone said, AP classes were tranquil, and you could do it all. SATs had nothing on you, and you were invincible until you went to the first day of school junior year and almost cried leaving first period. To everyone, junior year was a challenge, mostly because we were growing up and faced with more responsibilities. In sports, we were looked at as the new leaders and the experts of the team. Coaches and directors depended on us more, and teachers took us more seriously. This year was essential to our development. I think most of all, we learned, however, that monopolies were evil and that College Board was one that ruled the country. But we made it through that rigid year and did everything possible to make our senior year enjoyable. We made it through so much that any negative cliques or groups that developed with us so not including the muffs and guffs, dissipated by senior year. You went to senior trip together and watched our most enthusiastic and lighthearted peers dance their hearts out. We endured the fatal disease of senioritis together. However, to summarize majority of senior year, I have a short story I think some of you will appreciate. So I need two volunteers. I'll get one from this side and one from this side. All right, so we got Sammy, and I'm gonna use you. Okay. And Deshaun. Okay. All right, listen. Once upon a time, let's say Sammy and Deshaun. You guys wanna stay next to me? Sure, come on.
I'm doing good.
You guys can act it out too if you want.
No.
Once upon a time, let's say Sammy and Deshaun went out to eat. They haven't eaten in a while, so they invite their closest friends and family to spectate the feast. You guys are hungry, okay? The two students are carefully dedicating themselves to several pieces from the menu. The waiter comes and tells them that the special menu items have an early bird deadline, which happens to be today. Sammy and Deshaun make their final decisions and send away their order. The waiter comes back a couple hours later and tells him to give him about 6 to 8 months to process the order and come out with the food. That was basically the college application process. In the end, not all the food came out, and most of the food wasn't as appetizing as they thought. So they end up eating what they thought they wanted, but the meal cost about $500,000. Nevertheless, they survived, just like somehow we have managed to pick a college in our careers at the age of 18 years old. Impressive, I would say. Let's give these hungry people a round of applause. Thank you. Rather than talk about the bumps on the road and that we already know of, I want to leave you, class of 2016, with an important idea in mind. In today's world, and in our smarter, more technological generation, the idea of change is taboo. In a Twitter poll I held early in June, I concluded that we want to embrace change, but are scared it will hurt us. This idea isn't really bewildering. 18-year-olds would rather be stable and keep everything the same rather than deal with adjustments. But change is many times necessary, and we need to embrace it. In college, if you have to change your major, there's nothing erroneous with that. If you have to change your school, transfer. But more importantly, through life, if your lifestyle starts to go a different way, only you have the power to change it. And there's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing improper with starting anew. You don't need a formal end of a chapter, such as a high school graduation. Contain the will and be the author of your own unique story. I know many of you, like myself, had to change a majority of our surroundings, and as much as I personally feared it at first, I have no regrets, nor do I wish anything was different. The worst thing to do is to believe that you cannot acclimate to the new fluctuations in your life. Get rid of the friends that create obstacles in your futures and make new ones. Eliminate all sources of stress and stop worrying about the future, because in the end, every one of you is your own unique person, and you'll be able to make the best of the situation. Please understand that changes will happen in the next couple of years, and some will be unexpected. But with every one of these changes, we must grow. As Robin Sharma said, change is hard at first, a mess in the middle, and gorgeous in the end. So make sure to keep the end results in mind. Not that over there is our high school, because it's not there. Now, high school was our past. I've tried to keep it honest thus far, so therefore, let me straight up say that not everyone will be successful at first. In fact, no one. I do not care who. First, second, captain, or president. No one will succeed if one does not want to succeed and internally find motivation. We need to be able to acquaint ourselves to change and be able to get up, brush off the old dust, and collect new dust. By realizing these tangible ideas, we can work against them and strive towards a successful future. And with that, I challenge you, class of 2016, to change something in your future. Don't go through the next 4 years as you may have the last 4 years of high school. Don't get caught up in all study, or worse, all party. Instead, find a sweet spot in between. West Deptford, New Jersey is so small compared to the rest of this world, and the rest of the people in it. So don't minimize yourself, but instead soar outwards and expand your wings. Be accepting of others, embrace changes and differences, and don't let anything label you, including the past. Please appreciate and cherish the ones that help you finish a chapter such as this one. In the end, it's been a pleasure to have spent these many years with you, and I want to thank you all for simply being yourself. Oh, the places you'll go. Take on your next adventure and live life to its fullest. I better see one of you on TV soon, and if anyone makes it to any big event like the Oscars, I want a ticket. Congratulations to us all, and thank you.
Good evening, parents, family members, Board of Education members, faculty, staff, and most importantly, members of the class of 2016. Tonight we have gathered here to celebrate the most important annual event in our school community, commencement. I would like to take this opportunity to thank the members of our Board of Education, and our entire school community for your continued and consistent support of our district, even during these difficult economic times. I would also like to thank our graduates' parents for entrusting their children's academic futures to our district, and to recognize our administration, faculty, and staff throughout the district for the outstanding job that they have done working with these students for the past 13 years. It truly does take a village, to raise a child, and from my perspective, the Village of West Deptford is doing a great job. To the members of the class of 2016, congratulations. This is your commencement, the beginning of the next phase of your life. High school is over. You can cheer that. But now the future looms. What does it all mean? As you begin this next chapter of your life, set your sights high and strive to accomplish great things. Take the knowledge, skills, and values that you acquired during your time here in the West Deptford Public Schools and put them to good use. In the words of playwright Wendy Wasserstein, don't live down to expectations. Go out there and do something remarkable. You, the members of the very talented and successful class of 2016, have accomplished a great deal both collectively and individually in the past 4 years. And now it is time for you to turn the page and start the next chapter in your life. In closing, I would like to share this quote from an unknown author with you. I hope your dreams take you to the corners of your smiles, to the highest of your hopes, to the windows of your opportunities, and to the most special places your heart has ever known. Congratulations. Mrs. Cargill, it is with great pleasure that I present you the graduating class of 2016 for the awarding of diplomas.
On behalf of the Board of Education of West Deptford Township, I accept the graduating class of 2016. Good evening, everyone. Ralph Waldo Emerson once said, "The only person you are destined to become is the person you decide to be." Congratulations. Sitting here today, you are West Deptford High School graduates because you decided that is what you wanted to be. Of course, you had a lot of influences that helped you get to this point. Much of the course was laid out for you. At times, it may have been a struggle. Maybe you were frustrated. Maybe you went off the course and needed assistance to steer you back. Maybe you stayed on course, but still needed strong support and encouragement. The point is, you accepted that course, that guidance, and made a choice to do what was necessary to achieve this goal. As you move on, you will find that your own course will depend more and more on the decisions that you make for yourself. You will be the designers of that course. However, know that you're never alone. Your time here has taught you some important things. Beyond your formal education, it taught you things about yourself. I hope it taught you that there are people who truly care and want you to succeed. Your family, your teachers and administrators, your directors, coaches and advisors, and your community. Moving forward, continue to surround yourself with people who want to see you do well and take advantage of opportunities that support you in becoming who you want to be. As you travel through your life, your experiences will influence you, and you may find that you desire to redefine your career or even the person that you want to be. That's okay. Your time here at West Deptford has given you a solid foundation on which to build or rebuild. So rely on yourself, but know that you're not alone should you need help. Just remember to measure yourself against who you are and who you want to be. Be yourself. In closing, I go back once more to the words of Emerson. He said, "Make the most of yourself, for that is all there is of you." On behalf of the Board of Education and our community, I offer you the West Deptford Class of 2016, our congratulations and our best wishes for your future. You make us very proud. By virtue of the power vested in me as the president of the West Deptford Township Board of Education and by the New Jersey State Department of Education, I hereby award these diplomas.
Family and friends, please hold your applause until all diplomas have been awarded to maintain the dignity of the ceremony. Please refrain from calling out, whistling, or using any noisemakers that may interfere with every graduate's name being heard. Melissa Ann Bartley. Cameron Elise Arsenault. Rasha Mohammed Abulzadat. Matthew Curtis West. Gary Enoch Simmons. Sydney Elizabeth Cargill. Christian Monroe Streets. Connor Sean Ennis. David Joseph Munyon. Samantha Renee Budd. Annalise Joy Kipp. Catherine Lee Revellis. Jessica Marie Lindquist. Emily Marie Gilligan. Emily Lynn Cotter. Michaela Isabel Wilner. Mia Lee Forbes. Allison Nicole Plotz. Jacob Dylan Warlow. Caitlin Elizabeth Reichert. Ryan Joseph Denny. Kyle R. Gotchel. Michaela Patrice Clements. Alexa Marie Anderson. Brianna Nicole Austin. Avery Lynn Bailey. Samantha Jean Bergen. Emma Lee Blades. Alexis Noel Bame. Maggie Davis. Nicholas Xavier Diaco. Shaylin Marie Fisher. Pasquale Gismundi III. Jacqueline Taylor Hahn. Justine Haley. Lindsay Gwynn Harris. Kimberly Ann Hesser. Danielle Lynn Hout. Samantha Lee Iraldi. Emma Grace Kelly. Corinne Noel LaGrange. Christian Blake Lindaberry. Lauren Summer Maslinski. Luke Michael McEwen. Danielle Ashley McClaney. Matthew Francis Donald McSorley. Taylor Renee Moore. Alyssa Marie Palumbo. Nicholas John Paterna. Brendan Mackenzie Persichetti. Christina Catherine Petito. Alexa Bryn Petrassi. Nicole Carol Pullis. Rita Loretta Iannelli Prince. Jana Pearl Quigley. Walter Robert Reeve Jr. Isabella Catherine Ruskey. Sabrina Lauren Sacco. Tony Lynn Scola. Samantha Nicole Souder. Catherine Lynn Sproul. Heather Janine Ward. Benjamin Daniel Widener. Craig Ivan Abbott. Willie Earl Adams. Eric Edward Ainsley. Kimberly
Lynn Alexander. Heather L. Allen. Dominic Jean Oriema. Tynasia Monet Austin. Christian Paul Avellino. Zachary Tyler Baginski. Rachel Elizabeth Ball. Andre Derek Ballou. John Ryan Barrett. Jordan Brielle Kristen Bartlett. Wilson D. Bibler. Parker Otto Bonaventure.
Brooke Paige Bradley. Stephen Andrew Breen. Robert Somerville Brewer. Matthew Ryan Britt. Trevor Avery Carr. Devin Sage Carroll. Jason Sherwin Carter Jr. Samantha Joe Casper. Tyler James Cleary. Erica Taylor Colna. Michael Colville. Christian Michael Conaway. Tommaso Coppola. Brianna Providencia Costello. Alyssa Soraya Cruz. Gregory Diotavi. Gwen Alexis Decker. Ashley Lynn DeHart. John Joseph D'Elia Jr. Andrew P. Diop. Richard J. Dorenzo Jr. Justina L. Doherty Riley. Carly Alexis Dreyer. Colin Matthew Eckley. Chandler Elias Elliott. Caitlin Nicole Emick. Matthew John Ensman. Farah P. Fabriguez. Nicole Elise Fallon. Sean Alexander Fanslaw. Cameron Patrick Franson. Jade Rachel Freeberg. Carly Danielle Friel. Drew Edward Funk. Allison Elise Gallagher. Carol Ann Garrett. Jordan Garrity. Julia Catherine Gibson. Sierra Lorraine Gerard. Kara Elizabeth Goggin. Allie Marie Gordon. Thomas Paul Grassy. Richard Great Rex Jr. Deshaun Damon Stephen Green. Nathan Thomas Green. Stephen Austin Griffin. Bobby Ann Marie Gubby. Madison Rose Haley. David Allen Hamilton Jr. Cassandra Teresa Hammond. Kevin Clayton Harris. Justin William Hastings. Casey Lynn Habwa. Anthony Craig Hedman. Addison C. Henequin. Eric Hibbs. Caitlin Marie Hesser. Daniel James Hicks. Phoebe Lynn Hill. Wayne Dennis Hires III. Owen Conroy Hoffman. Rebecca Lynn Holdstein. Erica Monet Holmes. Nicholas Dean Horn. Davin Christopher Horner. Lucille Yvonne Jenkins. Shalaya Tariq Johnson. Nicholas John Capra. Desiree Jasmine Kearse. Sean Haslam Kelly. Jason Michael Kiesling.
Albert Joseph Kilpatrick III. Sean Robert Leeser. Joshua Edward Legg. Brendan Robert Lenhart. Jared Charles Lay. Caitlin Marie McDonald. Matthew Brian Mayen. Alex Joseph Malcolm. Mark Anthony Malloy. Viscount Basil Martin III. Marcus Antonio Malloy Jr. Arthur Wesley Matthews III. Timothy Joseph McCluskey. Erin Kristen McConville. Elizabeth Ann McCool. Jonathan Paul McCormick. Curtis William McDonald Jr. Michaela Paige Mahaffey. Nicholas Ryan Meyer. Brielle Emira Mitchell. Shane W. Moore. Austin Nicholas Moss. Aaron Alexander Olson. Stephanie Ortiz. Marquise Deshaun Owens. Denasia Aliyah Polk. Zachary Tyler Peterson. Julian John Pinto. Kevin Daniel Pizzatillo Jr. Gabrielle Cecilia Palamini. Nathan Aaron Poshwak. Elsie Sue Rossidi. Christopher James Raffley. Lauren Quinn Rasmussen. Brooke Nicole Rite. Corey James Reddington. Janasia Gloria Reed. Kaylin May Reichert. Ty Douglas Riley. Autumn Angel Roberts. Dominic Joseph Rappel. Frank Anthony Salvatore. Elijah Pedro Shabazz. Cameron John Shields. Tori Elizabeth Shivers. Jada Paige Simmons. Bradley Clifton Smith. London Gray Smith. Gianna Soli. Rebecca Marie Salameo. Laura Anna Sparacio. Zachary Rudolph Salameo. Michael Anthony Stauffer. Megan Ann Stephanie. Megan Renee Stemple. Matthew Christopher Sapansky. Fiona Ray Terranova. Danielle Alexis Turi. Nicholas Paul Tropiano. Kyle Franklin Ulrich. Derek James Wakely. Ryan Daniel Walker. Todd J. Watson. Michael Joseph Watts. Nicole Paige Weir. Andrew Kevin Weichel. Thomas Joseph Weir Jr. Andrew Stephen White. Mitchell Willichek. Julia M. Wilson. Gabrielle Lee Winter. Aiden Glenn Witherspoon. Carl Young Jr. Tyler Jack Yoler.
One more round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, the graduating class of 2016.
All right. Fellow graduates, I congratulate you. Please join me now for the traditional turning of the tassels. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise and join in the singing of the West Stepford High School alma mater. Welcome Dr. Gizmundi to the podium to present him with the senior class gifts. Yes. Dr. Gizmundi, on behalf of the class of 2016, I would like to present you two new TVs in the cafeteria. We're good.
On behalf of the faculty, staff, and future students at West Stepford High School, I would like to thank the class of 2016 for this gift. Thank you so much. Before we close out the evening, I actually would like to say thank you to a few people that actually helped tonight. I know this was a little different, unconventional, having our graduation inside a gymnasium. In the past, when they used to do the graduations inside, it's because it used to start raining in the middle. And that would actually, that used to take away the entire ceremony because people would run in and only two parents were able to see the ceremony. This way, we were able to provide five tickets and actually a really nice one. So I would like to, number one, start off with the RiverWinds staff, Greg Black, for all the help that they've had actually putting everything together for us. Most importantly, Myron Hall and all of his crew, the custodians, the grounds crew, they worked really hard in the past couple days, past couple hours to really put this thing together. As I said earlier, when we put this together, when you put a graduation together, it does not happen overnight. It's just something we plan and plan and plan. To go from an outdoor to an indoor ceremony, that takes about 10 to 20 hours worth of work that we were able to do within a 3-hour period. So special thanks to all my teachers, the staff, and everyone at West Effort to make this work today. It really is appreciated. So on behalf of the Board of Education, the administration, teachers, and staff, we officially want to congratulate our graduates and their families for a wonderful evening and a ceremony. We wish you the best of luck in all that you do and in the future. The ceremony is officially over. We do ask our, oh, it is over. Give a round of applause. Again, this is a little bit different. We do ask that all family members please remain seated during the recessional. Our students would be walking out. We don't want anyone in their way. So teachers, if there's people out in the hallway, please move them over because I want the students to be able to get right back into the gymnasium. Again, everyone else, please stay seated as we begin our recessional. Have a great night, drive safely, and thank you so much for allowing me to be the principal of your kids. Thank you.